Welcome back to Let's Play Stories Untold, Blind. I'm the RPG Chick, now beginning Story 3, or Chapter 3, The Station Process. The last one was a little crazy. Sometimes you may need to look beyond the screen to progress. Noted. So the first episode had us going into a house that was at first completely normal and happy, and then another us went into a house that was miserable and we met ourselves. And the second episode had to do with us examining some alien artifact, which turned out to be alive, or we woke it up and we joined it and I guess took over the facility or something. And now I have no idea what. The number 1986 seems to play a familiar role.
Station 3, do you read me? Give me a sign, man. This storm is getting pretty wild.
I can't read that.
Come on, 3. Log in. Quit fucking around.
Nah. Enter passcode. Well, there's the login. 0303-1968. Which is kind of like a jumble around of 1986 seems to be playing a role in all this. Can I click the mic? No. Can I click anything? AM/FM USB. Tune. Oh, really? Okay, well, let's enter the passcode. 03. So March 3rd, 1968.
There he is.
Finally. What took you?
No idea.
Is the microphone still broken in Station 3?
Guess so.
I'll take that as a yes.
Yeah, you can't reply. You should be able to hear you, though. Can see activity registering, so your voice is definitely going through.
Okay. We can chat later, 3.
Yeah, this is pretty serious. I've had a distress call from Central. There's a situation and we have to fire up signal monitoring and relay systems right away.
What kind of situation?
I don't know. I'm assuming it's got something to do with this storm. Whatever it is, it's big to want to involve us.
Shit. Okay, what do we do then?
Who are we?
Well, my fucking cabin power isn't holding up in this weather, so I can't process the signals myself. 2, you need to feed the frequency information through to the backup terminal in Station 3. And 3, you just need to tune, decode, and process. Just refer to the handbook on the microfilm. It'll walk you through it.
I've never done any of this stuff, so I'm not going to be much help, I'm afraid.
It's simple, honestly. You could do this in your sleep.
Okay. First one is due to appear in a minute or so. Have a quick read of that microfilm handbook. It should be on your left.
I'm going to get suited up and restart the generator. Don't fuck it up.
So I'm guessing we hit tab to move over there. So, monitoring Station 3, Greenland Research Base. Audio in is active, audio out is error, of course. Jay Asian.
Okay, 3, we're up. Do whatever it is you're supposed to do.
Transmission broadcast frequency. All codes must be treated as confidential. Do not write down the authorization key in any form. Well, that's fine, I don't think I can do that. Alright, so I'm assuming, like the other one, we hit tab to move over? Oh, brother. How am I supposed to read this? Forward, we thank you. Interesting. Okay. We thank you. We at the Control Monitoring Division would find... Thank you. I cannot read that. Operator role. Please note that any instructions carrying the GCS flag must be dealt with as a matter of urgency. Oh, that... Okay. That focuses... Oh! So I might actually be able to read this, then. That's interesting. I need to move... Oh, that's wonky. That is terribly wonky. Can I... We at the Central Monitoring Division would like to thank you for agreeing to commit to a year's service at your remote monitoring station. The work you do here is of vital importance to national security and something of our great nation. While you may never receive the explicit gratitude of our citizens, we will always be indebted to you. Operator role. An operator at one of our remote monitoring stations will be responsible for the following duties. The daily monitoring specified frequencies and the input of test data in a timely manner. In the event of a national security emergency, you'll be asked to monitor and input live something without question or hesitation. Carry out any maintenance needed on site to ensure the continual running of the station. Something should such an situation arise, all intruders should be killed on site, I guess. I don't know. You're instructed to meet with supply ships and ration food accordingly to ensure the station is continually well stocked. In case of something, your 14th and 15th molar teeth? I've got a poison thing in there. I keep trying to move it, mouse it, but you can't do that. Alright, let's go to the top. I can't get any further than that, can I? Oh, I can turn it! Oh, this is going to be delightfully forward. Okay. Central operations methods, message authentication, conversion handbook, eyes only. Well, what else would I use to look at it with, right? Something experimental sciences? Department of Experimental Sciences. The same one as in the first... Not the first, the second one. The one before this. So that's our forward. Contents. Morse code, phonetic conversion chart, GCS. What is all this stuff? Eagle, Sigma... Eagle. On receipt of this callback code, conversion operators must input the following command lines into the terminal and execute. Alright. Some code. Input terminal code, hitting enter at end of each line, type execute to run the program. Wonky! Okay, so we've got for all these codes, Sigma. Abacus, Portfolio, Kansas, we have variables here, Mask, Ingenue, what is it? We've got Canvas, Whiskey, Landscape, Orange, Centaur, Home, Jennifer. That's the guy's, his sister's name from the first story. Sacrifice, Drive, Chevron. Sibling. There you go again, sibling. What is all this? Appendix Morse code. Oh, I hope I don't have to enter this. Alpha phonetic conversion. Oh, brother. We got a flowchart here. GCS code word. Signal modulation. Oh, guys. Just be patient with me with all this crap, because this looks terribly complicated. GCS codes. Something E opens the verbal command speech or shout. They're all blanked out, though. V. V opens... obeys commands for movement. Closing. There's no closing. It never ends. No. Okay, what am I supposed to be doing again? I need to input a broadcast authorization key. I have to tune this, don't I? kHz. This goes by tens. It'll be quicker that way. What does this go by? Hundreds. 1930. Whoop. Thank you. Abacus. We have to do abacus. This is a system test. Traceback code is case sensitive, confidential. Alright, so we need to find abacus in here. Which is going to be all the way back to the beginning, right? Oh no. No, abacus is on page 6. Why couldn't they be in, like, alphabetical order? Here we go. Sys.exe-d-e. I'll do one at a time. D and E. Allocate, colon, 202? 2-0. That's not an 8, that's an O. Allocate, colon, 202-A. Space. Output log, false. Is it? Wait. Output log. There's no dot. I just hit enter. Execute. Enter again. Transmitting.
Okay, my light here just turned green and the signal stopped. So I think you did it right.
Yay! Private broadcast test.
Next one coming up in 30 seconds, apparently.
Waiting confirmation.
Don't leave them hanging too long. I don't know what they're for, but I know we have to make them top priority, or I'll get shit.
Of course, don't worry. We'll keep on top of it. Okay, there it is. Creepy sounding things, aren't they?
Okay, we need to go to 3,500 kilohertz on USB. 3,500.
Zero, one, two. 20,
You know what?
26 14 0 1 2
No.
26 14 0 1 2
Don't broadcast it that way. It's 26. Not 26. And then I thought we had to put dashes in for that one. Chevron we want. Chevron. Where are you? Page 20. It's after sacrifice drive. Let's go to the top. I'm past it. No, maybe not. Here we are, next one. Ref.inivwz. These are like DOS commands, kind of. Or like, Unix. Ref.init. That's a W, okay. Ref init WZ. Proc begin. Skip the next one after that. This keyboard is losing. Ref init. WZ. Oh. I can't go back, can I? That might be case sensitive. Get int XYZ in all brackets, caps, get int. Let's try. Mean? Oh, we're X second. Oh, I have to change that? X second, Y equals fifth, and Z equals sixth number from broadcast code. Second, okay, so 2, 5, and 6. 2, 5, and 6. What's the broadcast code? Oh, I got something there. Broadcast code. On receipt of this callback code, conversion operators must input the following command lines into the terminal, substituting any dynamic variables and execute. Second, fifth, and sixth number from broadcast code. What's the broadcast code? Let me just see if the first two are right. No. It's case sensitive. Case sensitive. Proc begin, this is case sensitive. Okay, we need to find a broadcast code. It's not my login, is it? The manual might say something else about broadcast codes. Whoop, I didn't want to hit that. I want to... Broadcast codes. Conversion chart? GCS chart? But I don't know what I'm taking it from. Morse code? Phonetic? What's the broad... I don't know what the broadcast code is. Go all the way to the end. See if we get any hint here. Broadcast code. Broadcast code. Property of U.S. Central Operation Message Authentication. 1986. There's that number again, guys. This really doesn't say much. But signal modulation, which in this case is USB. Hold on. I wonder if this tells us something. 3500 kilohertz. Okay, broadcast frequency. Neither of these two. Yeah.
Two.
Oh, that number?
20.
It's 20. Okay, that code. Duh. That's the code that was told to me. Alright. Crap. I have to go back. Okay, so 20. So X, Y, and Z. X is... So 20 was an actual 26. And then we want the fifth and sixth number.
Six, 14, 0, 1, 2.
Hold on.
26, 14, 0, 1, 2.
I gotta write it down. This really is...
26. 14, 0, 1, 2.
Thank you. Okay, so we've got Y is the... I can barely see in here. I need to turn my lights on. You know what? Hold on. Okay, lights are now on. So X is the second, Y is the fifth. 1, 2, 3. We got 4, so we got 0, 4, 0. Should be. Okay, I can't just go down. Okay. Does it still have to be in brackets? Maybe not. XYZ. Then it was 040. 040 20 6 14 012. Sorry guys, it's just driving me crazy now.
26 14 012.
Or was it 26? In which case it would be 601. Again, still, I don't know if we need the brackets or not. With brackets? I hit enter here. What did that do? Oh, it's... I can check it from here? Time back code is case sensitive, confidential. Unless that's not the broadcast code, right? Oop. 2, 5, and 6. That's not my login then. Again, I don't know if this has anything to do with it. Broadcast, that's broadcast, broadcast frequency, not broadcast code. Broadcast code. Unless I get it from here, phonetic alphabet. What is this? Alpha phonetic conversion. And there's Morse code. So funny how closing has nothing there. Yeah, I have no clue. Get int XYZ. Broadcast code.
Six, 14, 0, 1, 2. 26, 14, 0, 1, 2.
Unless... Wait. 20... Okay, so 6. This is 1, then. So 6 would be the second. And then 14... 0, 1, 2. So then it would be 2012? 2012? No. Maybe without the brackets. No, what the hell could it be? When I logged in, 20 was a separate number. So if it's 20, and then 6, then our first... Oh, what am I doing? What? Why did I put 20 as the first? This is, like, driving me insane. So 20... So 6 is the second one, then. So 6... It should be 612. Again, I don't know if we need brackets or not. Finally, transmitting.
Thanks, 3. Just pushing this update to the transmitter now. Getting the hang of it, huh?
Guess so.
Next one coming up. 1. What does GCS mean?
GCS? What do you mean?
Yeah, no, this next one has come through with an additional note. GCS 3 equals E1 V1 M1.
I've not seen it before. Check the microfilm. Might be something in there about it. Listen. Let me know when you're done with that one. I haven't heard back from the transport team and I'm starting to worry.
Sure thing. Okay, here it is. Whoa. Okay, that's different.
Flashing red screen.
Yeah, quite the warning sign.
Shit.
I wrote that down.
Something's going on. The last two must have just been testing the system. Tune it as normal and I'll see what I can find out once I get these goddamn lights on.
Okay. So we want AM 11320. I can't hold it down. I'm not sure how interesting this is to watch, guys, so I apologize if it's boring as hell. Especially that last part where I couldn't figure it out. 11320. It's Morse code. God damn it.